Hello and welcome to the training of the Sony Xperia S. First, let's take a look at the phone and look at the user interface before going through some tech stuff. So the Xperia S boasts one of the fastest standby captures of all smartphones. Basically what that means is when the phone is in sleep, if you hold down the dedicated camera button, in less than 1.5 seconds, you'll have a focused photograph. Even better, after you've taken the photo, you can do something to it like share it and post it to Facebook right away. Xperia smartphones also do Facebook integration really well, what we refer to as Facebook inside Xperia. And what I'm showing you right now is if you go to a contact on your phone, beyond just getting the regular phone and email, what you'll see is if they're a Facebook friend, latest tagged photos, as well as their photo albums, all in the contact section, as well as things like what they've been liking on Facebook recently. Music on Xperia S is also amazing. Either increase the loudness of the speaker using XLoud, or if you're listening to music through your headphones, check out a bunch of equalizers like headphone surround sound, studio, club, or even concert hall. The other thing you can do is when your music is displayed to you, you can change it around based on what you like. So you can either put your artists before your albums or throw your tracks after your artists. The beauty is, it's completely up to you, so try it out. Also, take the music that's on my phone and like it to Facebook. All I have to do is look for the thumbs up button throughout the phone, and what it'll do is it takes the track and actually creates a post right to my Facebook wall. I can even add a comment. I can also take the music that's on my phone and send it wirelessly to my other Sony electronics. I just hit the play on device button, look for the list like my Sony Bravia TV, and now all of a sudden I'm taking the music from my phone and playing it through my Bravia speakers. Xperia S has a brilliant high-def screen display as well as a fast 1.5 GHz dual-core processor. A very cool and underrated feature is how easy it is to take screenshots. So what I'm going to do is send the ferry schedule to my buddy. What I'm doing is looking up the route he needs to take, then all I have to do is hold down the power button. It gives me all the options, including down at the bottom here, take screenshot. So I do that, and then I can share it. He happens to be a WhatsApp buddy of mine, so I go down to WhatsApp, search for Chris here in my buddies list, and then what I'm gonna do is it automatically sends the photo to him. Music Unlimited is an awesome app that comes preloaded on Xperia S. It's a cloud-based music listening system that has over 15 million songs in their online database for you to look and cruise through. You have two sections, genres that you can go through music, or a My Music section, where you can do things like add songs that you currently own onto this cloud so you can take them with you wherever you go and don't have to worry about bogging down your storage space from your phone. Another cool thing you can do is create playlists, label them how you will, and create different ones based on the mood you're interested in. You can click on any song, you get some really cool playback features. The plus button down at the bottom would add a song to a playlist if that's what you want to do, or you can get more information. What's really cool is Music Unlimited likes to recommend songs that you can listen to, and if you're more curious about the artist, you can get bio info as well. So what is really cool is not only is Music Unlimited on your phone, it's on something like your PS3. Now, of course, not everyone has a PS3. They might have a Sony Bravia television. The idea here is this app is yours that works across everything. So I can even access it on my Bravia TV down at the bottom here. And what you'll notice is when I go into it, it's still my account and it still has the same playlists that I had when I showed you them on my phone. You really have access to your music wherever you go. I will forgive. What I'm showing you now is how to actually take something like a photo and share it onto something like a Sony Bravia television without any cables at all. You're on the same Wi-Fi network, so what I'm going to do here is go into a really great photo that I took when I was in New Zealand. Then I hit that play on button like I told you about before and select my Bravia TV, and there it is, great and crystal clear all the way across my Sony Bravia TV. What else is really cool though is if I take the HDMI out capabilities into play, connect it with my HDMI cable, all of a sudden I can now use my Sony Bravia remote and control my phone. What's really neat about this is the remote immediately turns into the exact same controls as if I was using my phone. So I can browse between photos if I want to, or I can hit the actual home button, and what I get is this really cool looking TV launcher. So what I can do from this is even use the play and pause buttons on the remote, and it plays and pauses my music from my phone, or I can use the arrows on the remote and go through the apps on the bottom. I can go to something like my browser, sit back on the couch, relax, and go through the web and see what's new from Sony Xperia blog. Okay, one of my favorite new features of Xperia S has to be that it's NFC enabled. NFC means near field communication. So what I can do here is we've got these things called NFC smart tags, and what they do is using the NFC reader of the phone, you just swipe your phone by the on the back, and what it does is it activates all these things at once. So rather than having to remember to launch your alarm, turn your ringtone down, turn your Wi-Fi off, Bluetooth off, GPS off when you get into the bedroom, all you have to do is swipe it by. Now I'm going to show you how you set it up. So what you do is hold down the home screen, go to widgets, and go all the way down to the bottom where it says Xperia Smart Tags. So there's my bedroom tag right there. Now if I really want to edit it and do some cool things with it, I just hit the bedroom tag, and then those are the applications I have it set up to. I can hit add action. What I'm going to do is say Bluetooth on, maybe I'm going to do set my wallpaper to that photo I was showing you guys before. I'm thinking, you know what, it'd probably be a good idea to play some music, and let's see what else I'll do. I think start an app. The beauty is, it's really up to you what you do, and you can add as many actions as you like. I like to, for example, what I'm doing here is even showing you how you can send an instant text to somebody on your phone. So now that means every time I swipe this tag, that text message would go to that person. So set up the tag and, well, set it and forget it. So how does that tag actually look, and what is it? How does it work? So essentially what you have here is this black tag. Cool thing is two of them will come in the box. You tag the tag, you put it on the back of the phone where the NFC reader is, and there you go. All the things I told the tag to do are now being activated. Here comes the calendar I told it to launch. I'm also playing my music now, and there goes that text message to that person. So it is really cool that now I don't have to remember to do all those things, which I just love because my short-term memory is pretty bad. but let's not overlook the fact that there are still people out there that are maybe getting their first smartphone, and you know, it's a little bit overwhelming to know exactly what they need to do. So let's say they have problems just figuring out how to turn on Wi-Fi. What you could do is just dedicate a tag completely to doing only that. So now all of a sudden the person doesn't have to know where to go on the phone, they just need the tag. Xperia S is Sony, so of course it's got Sony technology. XMOR for mobile is Sony CyberShot and Handycam technology, so you get great photos even in low light settings. The mobile Bravia engine is the screen display technology that they borrowed from the Sony Bravia televisions, so you get the greatest screen quality possible no matter your setting. Don't forget image stabilization and full HD recording. Enjoy that Xperia S smartphone, everyone.